She has obviously been intimidated.
Or tempted. Early parole is an effective lure.
Mrs. Reynolds, the only indication that a rape had occurred was Wilkinson's statement. She's now withdrawn that and alleged the attempted compromise of Governor Craven, a compromise in which she says you were involved. Now, that is evidence.
Coerced.
Perhaps. But until we verify that, I must relieve you of your duties as Governor of Wentworth. Mr. Craven will replace you in the capacity of acting governor.
Craven, I have been watching this desk for far too long to have you park yourself behind it. If I am not acting governor of Wentworth Prison before this afternoon is out, I change my testimony.
You try it and I'll drag you down with me.
You've already dragged me down far enough. I wouldn't bother with any more unpacking either. I've got a feeling you're just passing through.
I'll tell you what. How about I be your first best friend and you be my second best friend.
Yeah, that would be great.
And we could have secret pacts and special handshakes and everything.
Yeah, we could pretend all your other friends are here. I do it all the time.
Yeah, me too.
Merle, could you please stay with me just for a while?
Yeah.
And I don't enjoy being a governor without a prison, but I'm perfectly happy to share this one with you.
Sorry, Craven. You lost Blackmore, and while you're here, you'll answer to me the same as everyone else. Now get out of my chair.
Morris, obviously I'm the only person who's worried about Merle.
That's not fair, Kath. Of course we're all worried.
Yeah, she's probably standing on top of a skyscraper swiping a jumbo jet.
Shut up, Simpson.
At least she's not being raped by a pack of screws.
Now, quiet. That is enough. The governor wishes to speak to you.
On your feet and face the governor.
This way, ladies. Let me start by saying how much we will all miss Mrs. Reynolds. For some reason, she has seen fit to resign her post, and I know we all wish her well. The department has appointed me as her successor.
Quiet!
And until Blackmore is reopened, Mr. Craven will be my deputy. Now, those of you who know me will realize that changes will be made. Those of you who don't, namely our guests from Blackmore, we'll soon realise that I'm a very easy person to get along with, providing you do one thing, obey all the rules, religiously and strictly to the letter. If you don't, Wentworth will cease to be the pleasant home you've all grown to know and love. That's all I have to say. Carry on, staff. Maxwell, come with me.
At least she doesn't scream and carry on like Craven.
Yeah, so why have I got this funny feeling right now?
Oh, I don't know. I'm confused. I'm not. I'm scared.
I won't need you now, Mr. Craven. Perhaps you'd better change into uniform. You do have a uniform.
Not for the last 15 years, no.
Oh, I'll take care of it. In the meantime, I want all officers issued with batons and the perimeter guards to carry sidearms.
Me?
Yes, you, Mr. Craven. Now. All right, a couple of things I want to sort out with you two before we get down to the job. Firstly,
before
I think...
Before you start, Joan, I'd just like to say congratulations. I think you deserve it.
Two things. Mr. Adams, never interrupt me when I'm speaking and never ever call me Joan. Aside from that, yes, I do deserve it. Thank you very much.
Sorry.
I take it you're still top dog?
Yes.
Good. I want it to stay that way. I also want the shop run as a legitimate enterprise. No loading of prices and no contraband. Understood?
But what does
that... Understood.
Yes. Do you mind if I ask a question?
What is it?
I thought you were doing it for the money. I thought you needed it.
I have what I need.
I haven't. You know why I want that money. It's my future.
Well, now I'm your future, Maxwell. You watch my back, keep the women in line, and you'll have an easy life.
How am I supposed to do that if I can't give them anything? They'll only perform well if they know there's a reward.
So reward them. Tell them that after much discussion, you were able to persuade me to restore the after-dinner rec period. You'll be a hero.
That's it?
That's it. Wait outside for Mr. Adams. And Maxwell, remember, I'm your future. Any comment on what you just heard, Mr. Adams?
No. Well, I agree, if that's what you mean.
Close enough. There are some who wouldn't agree, though. In fact, there are officers who would disagree with my appointment as governor.
Well, I don't.
So you are to be my ears in the staff room, Mr. Adams. I want to know who those people are.
Yes, governor. Anything you say.
Anything I say. Yes, that's the way it's going to be from now on, isn't it, Mr. Adams? Anything I say.
Communication system died 8 years ago. I don't reckon any of our girls could read a pipe tap if you pay them.
Doesn't matter, we can teach them, right, Brum?
Yeah, no worries. I know how you've lived without it.
Is it hard to learn? It's a piece of cake.
Well, let's put it this way. Spike and Lurch are down in the basement, right? Yeah. Now, if I could be up here, I could have tapped a message at Pringles on her way down.
What if the screws learn the code?
Oh, they will, don't worry. That's where Spike gets really cruel.
I've worked out about 10 different codes. You just swap from one to the other.
You reckon Spider could top that?
No way. Tell you what, though, we're going to have to keep our eye on that bitch.
Yeah, I heard her talking before. It seems like Maxwell's the flavour of the month.
Well, I can't keep up with you. A couple of days ago, you wanted to kill the bitch.
Use your head, will you? She's in with the freak, and if the freak's on top, why bust a gut fighting? It doesn't make sense.
So it's stick with the strength, is it?
Look, if that's where the money is, why not?
What'd she say?
Look, shut up, will you? Let her speak.
I'm not going to pretend we haven't got trouble because we have. Big trouble.
Oh, you didn't have to tell us that.
So what did she say, Kat?
She gave us a choice. A quiet, orderly prison, or she'll engage every security measure used at Blackmore and let the Blackmore screws enforce them.
Did you tell her she could stick it?
No. I said we'd do as we're told.
Oh, you're a gutless wonder, Maxwell. What's the good of having a top dog who won't fight for us? Give the job to Rita if you can't...
Give the job to Rita. And we'd have daily cell searches. The shop would be closed. Every single letter that comes into this place would be cut to pieces. Hands up all the Blackmore women. Right, well, you tell this lot about the midnight visits. Is that what you want? Do you want to end up like Laurie Wilkinson? I don't.
I'm for Kath.
Yeah. It won't be easy, but at least we'll be able to sleep at night.
You're going soft, Maxwell. I say we put it to the vote. You or Reet. What? All those who want Reet back as top dog, raise your hands. Well, come on, what's the matter with you? You all know Reet can beat Ferguson.
And where is she now, in the pound? All eyes for Kat.
Thank you. Now, we have to convince Ferguson we're playing it straight. That means no scams and no contraband. But only for a while. Later, when things have calmed down, it'll be business as usual.
Getting slack, Adams. You're supposed to say stand against the wall.
Shut up, Connors. The governor's here to see you.
Wait outside, Mr. Adams.
But what if she attacks?
Outside. Connors and I are going to have a little chat. I've heard what you lot think about Reynolds. Nice lady. Fair. Well, perhaps she is, but that's why she's out and I'm in. I'm no lady, Connors, and every time I've tried to be fair with you, a lot have been kicked in the teeth, so it's not on.
Is there a point to all this? Because I'm getting bored.
The point is, from now on, Wentworth will be a model prison full of model prisoners.
And if it's not?
Oh, if anyone looks like discrediting Wentworth or me, they'll meet with an accident.
Are you serious?
Deadly.
And you've come here to ask me to behave?
I'm not asking you anything. I'm simply telling you, that's how things will be from now on.
Fair enough. Let me tell you something. I wouldn't get used to Craven being your deputy because he's a dead man. I'm going to kill him.
You're being stupid.
He killed my brother, Ferguson. He's dead. And if I ever find out you had anything to do with Laurie being raped, it'll be a double funeral. And that's a promise.
Your life, your choice.
If that woman
Joan expects me to walk around armed to the teeth with guns and bat, and she's got another thing.
Not guns, too.
Well, no, but what's the difference? We may as well be wearing them as far as the women are concerned.
Well, the perimeter guards have got them.
Ah, there was a time when you could have a joke with the women, but now...
She'll never learn, will she?
Oh, well, I'm not going to put up with it. I've had a talk with Mervyn and we're both leaving.
Oh, no, Joyce, don't do that.
Well, I must admit it's crossed my mind.
Well, I'm not surprised. Who in their right minds would make Craven deputy over you? It is ridiculous.
Yes, Joyce, I agree. But if you all walk out, what's going to happen to the women? They'll be left with the Blackmore staff, and you know what that means.
You see what I mean? They treat you like that, and yet you still worry about them. It is ridiculous.
Oh, and it's going to get worse.
I'd say that's up to us, wouldn't you?
You're going to fight back, aren't you?
Not if everyone's going to leave. I'd like a staff to come back to.
But how? I mean, what can you do?
Well, it's just the Board of Appeal, really. But if that fails, I'll go to the press. Be the finish of me, of course, but at least we get Craven and his thugs out of Wentworth.
Let's do it. I love a good fight. What can we do?
Well, I know what I'm going to do. First thing tomorrow, I'm going to ask Wilkinson why she changed her story.
Well, it's obvious, isn't it? She was threatened.
Yes, but by whom?
Craven. I don't think even Joan would do that to Lorelei, do you?
No. No. Perhaps you're right.
I'm sorry, Meg, but I don't agree. That woman is capable of anything.
Perhaps, but Meg, be careful. I don't want to sound too dramatic, but Craven's dangerous, very dangerous.
Double punishment on minor charges. 2 weeks loss of phone privileges instead of one. Implement 25-day solitary confinement as approved by the department. Reintroduce restricted buy-up, close shop. I don't think I need to read any more.
No, it's pretty simple.
I take it all this happened at Blackmore.
Plus a few things that I wouldn't put in writing. I can fill you in on those later.
No, you won't. You won't be needing that either. Connors will have the women rioting in a week.
I can fix her.
If and when I say so, not a minute before.
You're being stupid, Ferguson. I'm giving you good advice.
This is my prison, Craven. I will run it my way. If you don't like it, get out.
You seem to forget that I put you in that chair.
Correction, I kicked you out of it. And I was able to do that because you left yourself wide open to blackmail. Well, not me, Craven. I am here to stay.
Don't bet on it. That lot'll eat you alive. Do it my way.
Do it your way and I'll be out in a minute. Oh, I agree with everything you've written.
Then let's do it.
No.
Why? Because Connors mightn't like it? She's got you running scared, Ferguson.
She burnt your prison down, Craven. She's not going to do the same to mine.
So what are you going to do? Turn this place into a health camp?
Stick around. You might learn something.
Comes Lurch. You finished?
Yeah.
Oi, what are you two up to?
Here.
Hey?
Taste it.
Oh, your blood's worth modelling.
Where'd you get it? Bought it from Ross. Cost a bloody fortune, though.
Oh, Dobbin, how much?
I'll forget it. Next time.
Oh, thanks.
What's it feeling like out there?
Silly bitches. Just because they've got their after-dinner wreck back, they reckon Maxwell's solid gold.
They'll learn.
I doubt it. Tell you what, though, never thought I'd be drinking with two old tarts from Blackmore.
Plumber's here.
Has he got the blueprints?
Big roll of paper?
That's it, let's go.
I'll keep spying on her, mate.
What am I going to do with this?
Later, come on.
Oh. Up against the wall, Connors. I've just had a talk to Miss Ferguson. She's worried about you, Connors. Really worried. She seems to think all this trouble you're causing is the result of some deep-seated emotional problem.
I see. And you come to bash it out of me, right?
What? Oh. No.
Oh!
That's just the anesthetic, Connors. The doctors are waiting outside. Gentlemen.
Hey, to tell you, this mate that overblocked these toilets knew what they was doing.
Yeah, well, I'm not surprised. Can you do anything about it?
Yeah, no worries. It might take a little longer, that's all. Can you hand me that shifter?
Oh.
it's blocked. Take it to the one down below.
Shall I make it, Mr. Reynolds?
Oh, sit her over there and put her head between the legs. Oh, come on, I'll do it. Sal.
Hey, ease up, will you? You'll break your bloody neck.
Just relax.
What?
Relax and take deep breaths.
I can't hear you. You've got your fingers in my ears.
I said relax and take deep breaths.
All right, all right. I can hear you. I'm not deaf.
Who did it? Craven or Ferguson?
Craven and two of his hoons.
Oh, that bastard.
Well, you won't get an argument from me. Hey, do us a favour, will you?
What?
Tell the department. Don't let that bastard get away with it.
Don't worry, I'll be making a full written report.
No, no, Ferguson will bury it.
Don't worry, the department will find out. Now, can you stand?
Well, whistle God save the Queen, we'll find out.
Oh. All right, let's get you to the infirmary.
Get what you wanted?
Certainly did.
You wouldn't have a coloured pencil on you, would you?
Got a red biro. What about a blue eyeliner?
Great. Just trying to sort this mess out. How'd you go with the lover boy?
Don't remind me. If he had another brain, it'd be lonely.
Serves you right for being beautiful.
Yeah, sure. Hey, I saw a spider down at the shower block just after you left. Looked like she was up to something.
Who cares? We got what we want. You were a bloody lot of help, weren't you?
What do you mean?
Well, I'm supposed to be dying and you buggers nick off and leave me with Adams. He bloody killed me.
Hey, reckon we'll be able to get through to Rita?
I think so. See that red line?
Yeah.
Well, that's the hot water system.
Yeah, where are we?
Well, we're here and I think that's solitary. As good as a phone.
Hey, what'd you do with me coffee?
I was cold, so I tipped it out.
Oh, no!
Oh, what's the matter, girls?
Nothing. This is a private party, Simpson.
Yeah, I know why, too. You don't have to hide it, Marsh. I've got the original.
How'd you get that?
You're the communications expert, you tell me.
Don't get smart, or I'll take it off you.
No, you got it wrong, Jenkins. You can buy it off me. Take it off me, and I might have to have a word to the top dog about it.
Hey, Rita's been bashed.
Hey,
Peggy just got back from the infirmary. She reckons they brought in Rita and there was blood everywhere.
Oh, the rotten bastards! What's the top dog gonna do about this, Simpson?
Yeah, let's make her earn her money. Let's ask her.
What? I forgot to sign the shop book.
Didn't buy nothing.
You want me to look in your cell?
Only if I can come with you.
Just sign. And the rest of you, shut up.
Mr. Adams. What the hell's going on? There must be some news about Merle.
None that I know of.
Well, have you tried to
just
find
out?
Just
wait a minute. Don't use that tone with me.
Can't hear us.
It's got nothing to do with them. Just don't use it, okay? They might guess.
Well, I'm sorry, but I'm worried.
Watch your step, Maxwell. There's been another bashing.
Yeah, don't get him upset. He might be getting a taste for it.
What are you talking about?
Oh, God, here we go. You're going to tell us you don't know about it. Reet, some bastard worked her over in the pound.
Yeah, first Laurie gets raped and now this.
Didn't say nothing about this in the brochures. Oh, I'd have stayed at Blackmore.
Yeah, we all know who the bash expert is around here, don't we, Adams?
That was a bit stupid, wasn't it?
Well, what'd you expect us to do? Pretend it didn't happen?
Yeah, come on, Maxwell, you're top dog. What happens next?
Bugger the top dog. I reckon we do something
else. You're not using your heads. This was bound to happen. For God's sake, you don't attack a bastard like Craven and expect to get away with it. Connor should have known that.
She was sticking up for her mates.
There are other ways of doing it. I've already told you, if we use violence, we've had it. What happened to Connor's could happen to any one of us.
So what are we supposed to do? Wear it?
Yes.
Oh, you're a piker, Maxwell. We wouldn't let that happen. We'd stick together.
At night? That's when they do it. If we give trouble, they'll give trouble. If we behave, they'll behave. Now, if anyone disagrees with that, I'll step down and give the job to Alice.
we wear it.
Now, is that all he said? No mention of what happened in the dining room?
No. Look, I'm telling you the truth.
Keep still.
No one's saying you're not telling the truth.
Then do something! Bloody hell, what do you want? He's kicked me in the next week.
I'm trying to help you, Connors. If I took this report straight to the department, the wrong people could get it and tear it to pieces.
They will anyway.
Not if we're careful. That's what I'm trying to do. So what say we do it my way, eh? Now, did Craven say anything when it was over?
Not to me. He just went mad at the hoons for leaving marks.
That's when they scratched your shoulder with your own fingernails.
Yeah, they reckoned if you looked at my fingernails...
Yeah, I know why they did it.
Well, it's a pity you're not a typical bloody screw then, isn't it? Those other lying bastards
that
have
that kind of talk won't get you anywhere.
Oh, don't bet on it. Laurie's rape, and now this. They've had it. We've got them.
You can't count on the rape allegations. It's over.
What the hell are you talking about? She was raped! She's still in hospital, isn't he, Laurie? You still
in there? I haven't finished.
Oh, bloody hell.
She withdrew the charges. It's finished. Officially, there was no rape.
Like hell there wasn't.
Sister.
Laurie, what happened? He got to you, didn't he?
I'm sorry, Reed. I'm awfully sorry.
Don't worry, mate. We'll get the bastard.
Come on, Rita. Now you see why we have to do it my way?
Mr. Adams tells me you had a little accident, Connors.
Yeah, I accidentally bumped into a screw's fist about 100 times.
You've examined her?
Yes.
Self-inflicted or not?
Well, scratches on the shoulder are, but the others it's a bit difficult
to
tell.
I don't think so.
You need to be medically qualified to offer an opinion like that, Mr. Jackson. All right, Connors, who was it? Mr. Craven? He seems to be the popular choice.
You know what you can do with your Cupid doll, don't you?
I want proof, sister. I will not have my staff being accused.
That's not what's happening, Miss Ferguson. I saw the marks.
Then thank your lucky stars you weren't blamed. It won't work, you know, Connors. My prison is run on facts. Cold, hard facts. Now, I want those cards recalled. Yeah, anything with Ann Reynolds' signature on is to be reissued by tomorrow morning. Thank you.
Do me a favour. Don't send for me. I'm not used to it.
Get used to it. Read this.
What is it?
It's an entry in my day report book. It says that Rita Connors was bashed in solitary confinement. I have every reason to suspect you.
Bashed, eh? Sure she didn't dream it.
Don't be a fool, Craven. I told you not to touch her without my say-so.
And when would that be, Ferguson? Never? You're so scared of Connors, it's a wonder you don't ever put up for parole.
While you're in Wentworth, you'll do as I say. If you don't, I'll have you busted, and that's a promise.
Yeah? Well, you wanted Connors fixed, and I fixed her,
I
okay?
I didn't say that you would...
You didn't have to say anything, Ferguson. And don't play the sanctimonious screw with me. I've heard you're pretty handy with your fist, too.
But I don't leave evidence.
Neither did I. You're saying she was marked.
Yes, I am. So are Sister Hall and Marty Jackson.
Self-inflicted, eh? Connors must be getting desperate to pull that one. She's finished, Ferguson. You won't be needing this. You can just buy me a drink sometime.
Don't hold your breath, Craven. If anything goes wrong, a report will go to the department.
You've been hurt, haven't you?
Wait, take more than Craven to slow me down.
But I heard Sister Holt say that
it was a put on. Stop worrying, okay?
Wait, what's happening? Mrs. Reynolds has gone, hasn't she?
Yeah. Craven and the freak are doing a double act. They're not getting many laughs, though.
It's all my fault. I lied about what happened to me.
I know, love.
He found out about Zoe. And he said that and I couldn't fight that, Rita. I couldn't fight that.
Boy. He's a real sweetheart, isn't he?
Every time I go to sleep, I dream that he's in this room.
Well, he won't be trying anything like that. Not with the two of us. That bastard.
He did bash you, didn't he?
Him and two of his hoons. Real experts. They didn't leave a mark on me.
Your face.
I did that myself. If you ever want to feel a real deal, just sit on your bed, punch yourself in the face for a while.
They believe you?
I doubt it. But that doesn't matter, because that's not the reason I did it.
Reed, when the department finds out about Craven, I tell you what...
Craven's not going to find out. No one's going to touch Craven but me. He is mine. And this is the best place I can think of to get him.
Well, that does it. I'm not taking you overseas with all this bomb business going on.
Dear, and I had the bags all packed. You're mad, Mum. You always say that.
You want the jobs
vacant
paid, son?
And you always say that.
Well, you're going to have to start earning your keep sometime. Worked out what you're going to be yet?
Deep sea diver, wasn't it, love?
No, changed me mind.
Oh, uh-huh. What's it going to be now?
I'm going to be a criminal, like Merle.
Who's Merle?
Merle, I think she's on the front page.
Struth. I'd back her against the Sydney Swans any day. Have a look, love.
I don't know. I think she's got rather a kind face. A bit sad, really.
She's me mate. I'm finished eating. Can I go and play with her?
You said you wanted more stew.
Yeah, it's for Merle. Can she have some bread too? She'll be real hungry.
All right. You bring back that plate.
Yeah, I will.
Jelly Man, Captain Marvelous, and now Merle. I think we're going to have to get a bigger shed, love.
Do you like stew?
Oh, yeah, it's my favourite.
Oh, look, I got you some bread too.
Weren't you getting in trouble pinching that stuff?
I didn't pinch it, I said it was for you.
Oh, terrific. Jim, Merle and Muscles really like their new home. You got something for them?
Oh, yeah, I've got them some cheese. What have you been doing?
Been playing with your stuff and reading your comics and I tried to get in your sleeping bag, but it won't fit.
Oh, there's a blanket inside, I'll get you that later.
Tommy?
Yeah?
That big place out there is a house, isn't it?
Yep.
What's it like inside?
Well, it's just like a house.
Yeah, but has it got a rec room and a shower block and stuff?
Well, it's got a bathroom with a shower in it. Jeez, well, I thought everyone knew what a house looked like.
Yeah, I used to, but I think I've forgotten.
Madam, your table is ready. See on your phone? It's got an aerial and everything. No?
I bet Cass real worried about me. I shouldn't have just walked off like that.
You didn't walk off. You escaped. Pictures on the front page of the paper and everything. Dad can't say it's make-believe this time, can he?
I should phone her or something. I should let her know that I'm all right.
Oh, she'll be all right. Come, eat up.
So this attack took place at 3:30, is that correct?
Yes. Connor said that she heard the garbage truck arrive just before Mr. Craven entered. According to the gate guard, that was at 3:25.
And you're prepared to put your career on the line, are you, boy?
I don't think it'll come to that, Mr. Craven. Everything in that report is true.
How do you know?
When I found her, she was hardly in any fit condition to make up an elaborate story like that.
I was in uniform when the hangman had a job, boy, and they were still lying as they fell through the trap. So don't tell me about condition.
That'll do, Mr. Craven. I can't stop you sending this report, Jackson, but I would strongly advise against it. Mr. Craven and Mr. Stark were in this office from 3:20 to 3:45, filling out transfer forms for two of the male prisoners. It's on record, Mr. Jackson.
It can't be.
Well, it bloody is, boy. So who's lying? You, your girlfriend, the gate guard, or the governor? I'd suggest you don't say the governor, boy, or that'll really hit your career on the head.
Do anything like that again, Craven, and I'll destroy you.
Honest, Mill, there aren't any jails in the book.
There's gotta be, because I've seen Mrs. Morris answer the phone in reception. Hey, hold on. Would your mum know how to phone them? Tommy?
Oh, gee, Mel, I don't want you to call.
Why not?
Because you'll tell them where you are and then you'll have to go back.
But I've got to let Kath know I'm okay. She'll be worried because she's me mate.
I thought I was your mate.
Tell you what, you call.
Me?
Yeah, because I might forget and tell them where I am. You tell them to tell Kath that I'm okay and... We haven't even got the number.
Oh. Well, in that case, I'll just ring information.
Oh, yeah!
Filling out another fake report, are we?
Come here, Rodney.
No.
Your overtime sheet. You've got to sign it or else it won't go to head office. Who told you about the report?
I met Mr. Craven in the staff room.
Mr. Craven?
Yeah, the guy's a real pro, isn't he? Seen the way the women get out of his way in the corridor? They're scared.
Your real hero, eh, Rod?
Well, he is the boss of the toughest prison in the country.
Yeah, well, guess who made it tough? Oh, forget it, you're a bloody idiot.
I'm on the winning side, though. Wentworth Detention Centre? No, I'm afraid Maxwell can't come to the phone.
Well, can I leave a message for her? It's from Merle Jones.
Merle Jones, eh? Okay, kid, go on.
Well, just tell her Merle said she's okay.
And tell her not to worry.
Yeah, and tell her not to worry.
Merle said she's okay and not to worry. That it? Okay, thank you.
Hey, don't... Oh, you idiot.
Calm down, it's just a crank. I wish I had a dollar for every phone call we've had since a photo's been in the paper.
And how many of them knew that Maxwell was Merle's friend?
Oh, no.
No, Sergeant, that was all that was said. Then the boy hung up. Oh, difficult to tell. Mr. Adams seems to think he's about 7 years old. Yes, certainly, Sergeant. Thank you.
Well, the kid would have hung up anyway. I mean, he was hardly going to give me his address, was he?
He's a child, Adams. Didn't it ever occur to you to try and trick him out of it? Oh, of course not. What am I thinking of? You're no mental match for a seven-year-old.
Look, I'm not going to wear that. I was smart enough when you wanted me to bring contraband into the place. And what about asking me to spy on the staff? I mean, how good would that look if it got out?
Got out? Good God, it's fighting back.
Well, no, I'm not. It's just that
I think we've got something on the governor, do we? Think we're on a good thing, is that it?
No.
Then what is it, Adams? What possible excuse could you have for talking back?
Well, it's just that I'm always the one who's wrong, and I'm not. Not all the time.
Oh, get out of here.
Place is like a bloody morgue.
Yeah.
I'm not kidding. Even your screws are jumpy.
Eh?
Russell and Radcliffe. They're not bad sorts usually. They haven't cracked a smile all night.
Yeah.
Rita busted a gut for this lot and they couldn't care less.
Yeah.
You know, everyone reckoned that Merle was enough. Who's got the last laugh now, eh? She's out. We're stuck with that old Ferguson.
Yeah.
Will you stop doing that? I feel like I'm talking to myself.
I'm sorry. I'm thinking about something.
Oh, don't let Maxwell hear you say that. It's probably against the law.
How do you reckon you'd go as a gorilla?
How'd you like a smack in the mouth?
Oh, come on, will you? I'm serious.
So am I. This isn't the time for monkey jokes.
Oh, not gorilla. Gorilla. Partisan? Saboteur?
Oh, like them French blokes in the war movies.
Yeah, that's it. You, me, Brumby and Lisa.
I'm not with you.
Well, our trouble is we've been doing all our fighting up front. It doesn't work, does it? You end up in the pound and get bashed like Rita.
So?
So we go underground. Sabotage the machinery, stink bombs in the air conditioning, set off the fire alarms. I promise you, by the time we'd finished with the freak, she wouldn't know if she was coming or going. What do you reckon?
Here you go, mate. Two sugars, okay?
That's for me?
Yeah. What are you trying to do, kill yourself?
Still trying to figure out the coffee. What are you talking about?
This.
The roster, what about it?
Well, look. Split shifts, Monday, Wednesday and tonight. All work and no play, old son. You won't be worth a cracker.
Rodney, cut the bull. Isn't it time you were going home?
I swapped with Faye Gorman.
Oh, yeah? Why?
So you wouldn't have to do the double on Wednesday. I mean, you should have said something. Hell, I know we're not mates, but you...
Rodney, we don't even like each other. In fact, I think you're a nerd.
Yeah, but that doesn't mean we can't help each other, does it?
You're unreal. Look, if you want something, ask. I'm busy. I'm
just trying to be nice. Look, Marty, about that phone call from Merle Jones.
Ah, the one you hung up on.
Well, that's just it. I didn't. Well, I did technically, but only because I knew he'd hang up first.
And if someone from the department should ask, you want me to say that the kid hung up on you?
Well, you know, it wouldn't hurt.
Wentworth Detention Centre. Yes, sir, I'll just get a pen. Anything else, Rodney? Right, sir, go ahead.
time is it, Laurie?
5:36.
A bit after, I reckon. Two screws in the dining room, one in reception, two in the dorm area, and I reckon Craven will be taking his break in the staff room. Does that sound right?
Reed.
Does that sound right?
Yeah, but what are you gonna do?
I'm gonna kill Craven. Well?
Someone has to.
Yeah.
But I wanna help. I wanna make sure that nothing happens.
You can help. But you must stay in bed. You've got to promise me. Drop your tray. Sister Hall!
Laurie, you all right?
Oh, don't worry, I'll pick it all up. I'm going into the examination room, and you're going to call reception. And you're going to say just what I want you to say.
Better smarten up on the typewriter, boy. Never know when you'll be looking for a job.
Good night, Mr. Craven. Mr. Craven, don't forget to sign out. I'd only have to ask the gate guards to send you back. Reception. Yes, he is. Hang on. Sister Hall would like to see you in the infirmary.
Tomorrow.
She seemed a bit worried. Said that Lorelei Wilkinson was saying some very strange things under sedation. He's on his way.
Spend some time in here with Laurie.
Anyone coming?
No. Need any help?
Not yet. What'd we get up to?
Stink bombing kitchen.
I don't know about the kitchen. Don't want Mervyn spitting the dummy.
God, no. We'd starve to death. What else?
Don't know. Depends on who's mustered where. We could knock out the workshop.
How?
All on the floor. One of those galantines will do the trick.
Just so long as I'm not the one who has to clean it up.
Doesn't matter as long as out of action. Come here, quick.
Put your finger on that.
Got it.
Hey, we can use the plans we got from Loverboard and knock off the hot water.
Yeah. Hey, what about the fire alarm?
Oh, good idea.
Geez, we're gonna be busy.
Who cares as long as the freak's upset?
Vanita.
Quick, come on, let's get out of here before we get caught.
Sister?
She couldn't make it.
You missed your chance, Connors. You should have done it while my back was turned.
Oh, no way. I want to see your face when it happens.
You want me to tell you how many times I've been through this sort of thing?
I know. You must be getting pretty sick of it. So I'll make sure this is your last.
All right. Who goes first?
She wouldn't hurt you, sister. She wouldn't hurt you.
You're a fool, Connors. One way or another, you'll die in this place.
As long as you die before me, I couldn't care less. You destroyed people, Craven. You destroyed my brother. You destroyed Laurie, and now you want to destroy a kid.
A deal? I'll give you a deal.
Stick your guns. I'm going to kill you. What's
so special about Wilkinson, anyway? He's only a slug, you know that. A kid of hers is no better. She'll be on her back earning dope money by the time she's 12.
You bastard!
Okay, Connors. It's up to you whether she lives or dies.
Stop! We had him. We had the bastard.
Get on the phone and call reception. Get on the phone!
Sorry, Rita. I'm awfully sorry.
You could have killed you, Connors, you know that.
Don't talk, just get her inside.
Oh, I've changed your mind about her, haven't you?
Open the door.
That's government property, Connors. I think you're in enough
trouble
without
having to... Let's go, Mr. Adams.
Ferguson's right, you're just as bad as your mother.
This place will collapse the minute I leave. You couldn't control a fowl house, Ferguson.
Why don't you let me know when you're ready to talk, Craven?
Why the hell did you do it?
Why would anybody leave two prisoners like Wilkinson and Connors without a guard? What are you trying to do? Get somebody killed?
I can't hold your hand all the time. If you're stupid enough to fall for a trick like that, you deserve everything you get.
They should have been under guard.
If it hadn't been for you, they wouldn't have been in the hospital in the first place.
She has to go, you know that, don't you? If she doesn't, she's going to bring this place, your prison, down around your ears.
Oh, so now we're looking after me, are we?
I'm looking after both of us. Do you want me to tell you what'll happen if you let Connors live?
She's in solitary, Craven. Dead bodies are very difficult to explain away in solitary, or hadn't you heard?
Then we'll move her down with the other women.
No, forget it.
We've got to. If she talks to the right people, we're done.
We are not killing Connors.
All right. Then let me have some time with her alone. We can use the punishment cell that Reynolds set up. When she complains about being bashed, we can blame it on the other prisoners.
You think you can do it?
I wrote the book.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Bailey. I simply don't have any medication for her. We've had some trouble here and... But it's simply not true. Now, don't take any notice of her. She'll be perfectly all right until the morning. I'm sorry, I have to go.
Lorelei, get back to bed.
Sister, no one will tell me about Rita.
Now, don't you worry yourself about her. Get back to bed.
And if she's in trouble, I want to know.
Of course she's in trouble now. Come on.
Nobody understands what she's doing.
I know what you're doing. You're being very difficult.
No, I'm trying to help her.
Now, listen, if I don't see a marked improvement in the next few hours, you're not going back to your dorm in the morning. Do you understand?
Sister? What do you think of Craven?
He knew how to handle Connors.
No, I don't mean that. I mean, as a person, what kind of a man do you think he is?
What's that got to do with anything?
Please, I want to know.
Well, he's always been pleasant to me. You can only take people as you find them, can't you? Now, you rest.
Pleasant. Nobody understands what's going on in this place.
Why was I taken out of the pound?
Because the governor said so. Now, shut up.
There's a reason. You know that, don't you?
Connors, you were told to shut
it's
up.
It's all right, Mr. Adams. I'll handle it.
Listen, can I talk to you? It's important.
No, you can't. Now, move.
Mr. Adams, I want to speak to you about that overtime sheet you signed.
Are you mad? What the hell are you talking about that for?
You've claimed for 11 hours more than you worked.
Yeah. Why the hell are we talking about it now, for God's sake?
Because Connors wants to talk to me and you're going by the book.
So?
So if you don't bugger off for a few minutes, I'll go by the book and submit a fraudulent payment report. You know what the department would think of that.
You're joking. That was a mistake.
Prove it.
We'll wait around the corner.
And I won't look around. Craven's trying to kill me.
Come on, he might be a bash artist, but you're talking about murder.
Then why did he take me out of solitary?
I won't buy that.
He can't kill me in solitary. It's too hard to explain. Down here, he can blame it on the other women.
So what do you want me to do about it?
I want you to tell the department. Then tell him you've told them. He wouldn't try anything then.
They'd just laugh at us. For God's sake, you're the one who tried to kill him, not the other way around. He'd come out looking like a martyr.
He's trying to kill me!
Look, if we don't hurry up, they'll start asking questions.
I think you're wrong, but give me time to think about it.
Come on, Connors.
Hey, Lurch! Can
Shut
you
up.
Hear me?
I'm warning you.
Is that you?
They're taking me off to the punishment cell. Craven's after me, so if you hear anything, start yelling.
Why? What happened?
Just do it!
Spike, what are we going to do?
Just what she said. We'll do it in 3-hour shifts, okay?
Right. Lisa and me will take the first.
Jeez, I wonder what happened. Rita sounded real worried.
All right, Connors, you know the score. This is a punishment cell. There'll be no communication of any kind. Anyone found passing you
As
any goods
said,
will be...
Mr. Adams, she knows the score.
Listen, I'm getting a bit sick of this, mate.
I'm sorry, Mr. Adams. Perhaps we should discuss it after I've sent that report to the department. If it'll make you feel any easier, I'll stay in the building until Craven leaves.
Serve me, Connors. You know what has to happen, don't you? You're gonna die. And you're gonna die in this cell. Or not now. But it'll happen.
He used to give.
give me roses. I wish he could again, but that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare, awaking up alone. On the inside the roses grow, they don't mind the stony ground, but the roses here are prisoners too, when morning comes around.